Welcome back to my channel. This is your first time here, you're highly welcome to my old subscriber. Thank you so much, you guys are amazing. Yeah, like before it was fully blown in Germany, I do reach out to them and ask them how are they doing, but now that we are facing the reality, it's just tiring, and staying at home, we have to do that. It's not easy, but we have to do our best to stay at home so that it will start decreasing, and we'll pray for hope very soon. And then I'm just sad about the way the thing is going. Like, you don't get to buy, you go to the supermarket, you don't see some certain things to buy, and you have to get milk for my son. I went to the supermarket several times. I said, okay, maybe because I was going in the morning, let me also change and start going in the afternoon. I went twice in the afternoon, I couldn't get milk. I said, okay, let me try in the evening. I went again, and the last time I said, okay, let me just ask. Since I saw some people coming out, I think people that were on queue, they had like three tissues, like three women were holding three tissues and three tissue rolls, and it was not displayed on the, in the place where they usually put it. So I said, okay, let me just ask them. Maybe they are keeping it inside. If you want to, if you want, you can ask, and they will just give you what you want, you know. So I talked to the woman at the counter and told her, please, I need a milk. I don't know if it's available. She said, no, if you don't see it there, it means it's not available. You don't have to ask me. I was like, ah, calm down now. We are not quarreling. So I had to go back home. When on my way home, I saw my neighbor, and I told her, ah, you were looking for tissue paper the other day. Like, they have it now. I saw two women holding tissue, so you can go and buy. She went there, came back, and she told me that she came with milk and tissue. I was like, ah, how did you get milk now? I've been going there. She said, she got there, she asked them for tissues. They said they don't have it. She said, why? But somebody was here and they bought tissue. As in, four people, they've left there with tissue. Why is it that you don't want to sell for me? She's a Cameroonian. So she was like, you have to give me tissue paper and I need milk as well. So when they were trying to still talk to her, no, we don't have, she said, okay, I have to call the police. And at the end of the day, they gave her tissue. They said, okay, you can only buy one. She said she doesn't even need to. One is enough. They gave her one tissue roll, tissue paper, and they told her you can also buy milk, like you can buy two. She also picked two. When she told me, she said, you can go now and buy. I said, no, I don't want to go back. Like, I don't understand. Are they holding these things, or I don't know? Or they are selecting the people they are selling it to. A friend of mine actually went to DM drugstore to buy diaper. I asked her to, please, if you are passing by, just help me get diapers since I can't go to the town and you are already there. She said, oh, fine, no problem. She was there before 9. They usually open 9. They didn't allow her to stay at the front of the shop. So the security said you have to wait somewhere else and all that. So immediately they opened at about at 9 o'clock. They asked her, what do you want to buy? She said she wants to buy diaper and wipe. They said, okay, we don't have it. You can't go inside. She said she went to buy something else. I can't remember. They said they don't have it. She now called, she was on phone all this one. So I was like, why are they not open now? They don't have it, they don't have that. Okay. She now told me that she will take go to the other DM that is like 5 minutes walk from her place. She'll just try and see if that one is there. When she got there, she was able to enter and told that you can only buy one diaper and wipe. And I was so happy. I said, I thank God at least I have this one in the house, and it was fine. So I don't really know how it is in other places. I don't know if you are able to buy things. Like, for the past 2 weeks, I've not seen pasta in the supermarkets, of which I don't really know. But today, I was able to get pasta, and they said you can only buy two. Fine, it's okay. If I should go maybe some days after, and I can also get two like that. I know it's just going out. It's not really nice. But when you lack some things in the house, sometimes you just improvise, or you can go out and buy. So I'm just reflecting, God, what was really going on? I can't wait for all this to just be over. And now that is in Nigeria, God help us. Now that is in Nigeria, I really don't know what the government, I don't know what they are doing about it. Like, they don't even have, I'm not sure they have centers for this whole thing. But I now remember, like, those houses they were destroying one time that it belongs to the government, it's a government property, and they stolen, they used stolen funds to build it and all that. And instead of destroying those houses then, I think now those houses would have also served as a center to put these people that have this virus, you know, to put them there and as long as we pray, I just pray it doesn't escalate in Nigeria because we will not be able to handle it. If Europe are still suffering, coping with the kids at home, what are you doing? What are the activities you are doing? Please share. I would like to know what you're doing with your time. Let's participate. Let's do something together, you know, because staying at home is so boring and for the kids as well. So are you coping? My next turn. Bye.